Hey, hello, Aurora campus family. It's Pastor Mark. I just wanted to let you know, what you're getting here is a re-recording of our sermon from November 29th, yesterday. We had a little technical glitch, so we thought we would re-record it and put it together. I hope you enjoy it.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Christ Community Chapel, Aurora campus. My name is Aaron Arnold. I'm the worship director here. We're so glad that you've been able to join us online and that we're still able to live stream our services to you during this time. So even though we are scattered, we are still the church, and we will still remain united in the message that we hear and what we give out to our communities. Let me pray for us before we jump in this morning. We are beginning Advent. It is an exciting day. And we have a beautiful song to kick us off, O Come Emmanuel. Pray with me now. Heavenly Father, thank you for this time. Thank you for your presence with each and every one of us, and that you do speak to each and every one of us. We thank you for your word. We thank you for the truth in these songs we're about to sing. We thank you that you sent Jesus for us. We sing of his first advent, and we look in this song not only at his first, but we look forward to his second advent and his coming to make all things new and all things right. Bless this time that we have this morning. It is in your most holy name we pray. Amen. Sing with us.
Israel.
Thank you, Aaron, and our worship team. That put me in the Christmas spirit instantly. What a great job. Good morning, everybody. Missed you guys already. Looking forward to the time we will be back physically together. But I love that the church is gathered virtually, that we are together. My name is Mark Lyle. I'm the campus pastor here. It's a great joy for me to be your pastor. I want to say good morning. I think there probably are some of you who have never been into our building, that you are visiting because someone invited you or you heard about it on social media, and I'm glad you're here. My prayer already has been that this service will be a blessing to you. We are kicking off Advent today. This is the first week of 4 weeks that lead up to the grand celebration of the birth of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who is Emmanuel, God with us. And our tradition each year is to have a theme. This year our theme is Behold the Gift of God. My desire for you is that through what we say, through how we worship, we will hold out in front of you the gift of God, and that you will behold its beauty and its excellence. You will see that it is a good gift and that every good gift comes from the Father. So each week we're going to pick one facet of that. Then we're going to look at peace. Then we're going to look at love. And finally, we're going to look at the gift of joy. And to help us, we sometimes as a church, we symbolize things. And it's been one of our great traditions as a church here to light an Advent candle as part of an Advent wreath to remind us of those different aspects of the gift of God. And so we have the Merkel family and the Mackey family with us today to help us with the lighting of the Advent candle. Guys, thanks so much for joining us today.
Good morning. My name is Carla Merkel, and I'm on staff here at Christ Community Chapel Aurora. This is my wonderful husband, Bill, and our daughter, Sarah Mackey, and her husband, Christopher Mackey. And I run our care ministry, help out with women's ministry, and do our food ministry.
Today, we will be reading from Isaiah 9, 2, and then 6 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who dwelt in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shone. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government of peace there will be no end, on the throne of David and over his kingdom, to establish it and to uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time forth and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this.
Let's have a short prayer. Oh, our God and Father, we give you great thanks that you took the Word that was the creator of all things and you made him become flesh. And you gave us a gift of great hope that in a small village to a small tribe was born a human baby, fully human and fully God, that your Spirit may come into our hearts and write your law there. Lord, we pray that you will set a fire of hope in us in this Advent season, that we will remember that you made yourself so approachable by going so low to make you reachable by us, and that through that we can know the wonderful Savior, the great Counselor, the King of Heaven. We pray this all in the name of our Lord Jesus. Amen.
Let's continue to sing together.
Who is like unto the Lord our God, who dwelleth on high, who dwelleth on high? Who is like
story. It made your beauty known. You created nothing that gives me more pleasure than you. You won't give me something that gives me more pleasure than you. You who hung the planets, your image you made man. I'm overcome and broken at the wonders of your hand. You created nothing that gives me more pleasure than you. You won't give me something that gives me more pleasure than you. Than you. You won't give me something that gives me more pleasure than you. You created nothing that gives me more pleasure than you. You won't give me something. Gives me more pleasure than you.
Who is like you to the Lord our God? Who dwelleth on high? Who dwelleth on high? Who is like you to the Lord our God? Who dwelleth on high? Who dwelleth on high?
Haste, haste to bring him love.
Father, thank you so much for this time to sing together and the truth in these words. Thank you for your power, how you created all things, and in your mercy, your grace, your wonder, you sent us Jesus. Thank you for that baby who was born, your son, truly God and truly man, proceeding to the cross and securing our salvation. Would you speak now through your word? Remind us of this throughout the week. Let us not forget all that you've done and all who you are during this time. We thank you so much. It's in your most holy and precious name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, Aurora Campus family. It's Pastor Mark, and I want to welcome you to Advent. It is a great time for us to be together. It's a tough time, too. We know that with some of the restrictions we have, it's going to look a little different than Christmas has looked in years past. But as believers in Christ, we get to take each week and we get to celebrate the birth of our Savior, the truth of God taking on flesh. It is truly mind-blowing, and we're going to celebrate. I want you to know, this year we pick a theme every year, and this year when I sat down to pick a theme several months ago, we came up with Behold the Gift of God, and I want to tell you why that particular theme. I actually have been known to be a little grumpy around Christmas. I don't like all the commercialism, and I've even tried to teach my kids from a young age, try not to focus on the gifts of Christmas. And yet here I am picking a theme that says, Behold the Gift of God. But what I started thinking was, well, let me give you an example. When Anna and I had our kids and they were still very young, one of the horrifying moments of the holiday, of Christmas specifically, would be if one of our kids received a gift and we got the sense that either they didn't like the gift or even worse, that they weren't thankful for the gift. Probably, if you could see Anna and I in our early days, we probably even jumped the gun at times in saying, oh, make sure you go over to Grandma and give her a hug and thank her for the gift. Because we just couldn't fathom, or we absolutely did not want our children to grow up and not be grateful. And that really hit me in the heart this Advent season. Because I started to think, for you and for me, as believers in Christ, what if we aren't really realizing what the gift of God is in Christ? Or worse yet, what if we don't show any gratitude to our Father for the gifts that He has poured out on us? So each week, what we're going to do is I want to show you one particular aspect that I think is true and powerful of the gift of the birth of Christ. And I want us to try to hold it in our hearts and in our heads and really see the value. In fact, that's one of the questions we're going to tackle each week is, why is the gift valuable? And then what happens when the gift hits our hearts? What does it mean when we receive it? And then lastly, I want to look every week at, is it possible for us to give this gift away? So this week, the gift that we're going to look at, that God has given to each of us in Christ, is the gift of hope. Let me look with you at the passage that I think God has for us today. It's in Luke chapter 1, and feel free to follow along with me in your Bibles. It starts in verse 26. It's going to be familiar because the Christmas story is, but my hope is that we see it maybe just a little bit differently this year. It says this, in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth to a virgin betrothed to a man whose name was Joseph, of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and he said, "Greetings, O favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was greatly troubled at the saying and tried to discern what sort of greeting this might be. And the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus." And I want to stop right there just for a second, because sadly, I think the truth of our world in celebrating Christmas is that we stop right there. In fact, even when we are at our best, we stop right there. Here's what I mean by that. If you're to stop a friend or email a friend this week or talk to somebody that's just an acquaintance and you say, "What is Christmas?" You know where they're going to go with this. They're going to say, "Oh, Christmas is an American holiday that, oh yeah, I think it has some roots," or we get a day off of work and we all do this present thing, and it's a great season for shopping and for retail, and families gather, but unless they've grown up in faith in Christ, they are probably not going to say Christmas is the celebration of the birth of Jesus. For what purpose? Right? If we stop right there at verse 31, it would kind of be, "Hey, congratulations, Mary. God really likes you, and he's going to give you a baby." And she said, "Well, I'm not even married yet. Why am I getting a baby?" "Because babies are great." Well, babies are tough. Babies are a lot of responsibility. But is the gift more than the baby? Of course it is. Let me give you I want to tell you something that happened in our family that made me also think about this whole idea of what's the gift beyond the gift. Last Friday night, my daughter got engaged to her now fiance, Joey. Our daughter Grace and Joey have been dating quite a while, and they have decided that they are meant for one another, that they want to spend the rest of their lives together. And so Joey surprised Grace by arranging a fake tour at the Ohio Theater in Playhouse Square. And out in the middle of the stage, there was a stool with a ring on it. And eventually he got her out on the stage, and she didn't know it, but we were sitting off to the side. He had invited us to come up early, both families, and we got to see what happened. And it was wonderful and joy-filled. But he walked out there and he grabbed that ring and he turned and he got on his knee and he said, "Grace, will you marry me?" And we went crazy. But I started thinking over the weekend, what if for some reason Gracie decided that the gift that was given to her was a ring? It was a ring, but it wasn't just a ring. If she came home and she said, "Hey, Mom and Dad, look at the ring," and we did, "Wow, it's beautiful, it's spectacular. Isn't this great that I now have a ring and I didn't have a ring?" And if we as her parents all of a sudden realized she thinks that the gift she was given was a ring, the gift she was given is way bigger than the ring. The gift she was given was stability and love and security and purpose and life. And when Jesus came to us, well, listen to what the rest of the description is about Jesus in Luke. It says this in verse 32. "He will be great, and we will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end." The gift is not just a ring. The gift is not just a baby. The gift of God is hope. What Mary experienced, and ultimately what we get to experience because of this truth, is that God said, "Mary, I'm giving you what we come to know ultimately as my own son. And not only will he live for you, and not only will he die for you, but he will take and he will, when you receive the gift of hope, he will transform your brokenness. He will take your despair. He will take your dread. And he will turn it into victory. And it's real, friends. Mary did not get to see any of what was promised. She didn't see Jesus sitting on the throne of David. But the moment that that angel delivered the message, she had hope infused into her life. And so this year, this Advent season, I want to start this first week with saying, let's hold in our hands, in our hearts, in our heads, the beauty of the hope that God has poured out to us. Now, if you're saying to me, hey, Mark, I need to understand a little bit more of maybe what it feels like, I think I can give you a pretty easy parallel to that. In March of this year, we had something happen that none of us have ever experienced. You know what I'm talking about. It's with us every day. It's on our minds all the time. It's in almost every conversation we have about our lives and about our work and about our social and our recreation. We know, because what started happening in March was we started to experience fear. And we started to experience dread, and we started to experience despair, and we started to look at life and say, what happened to all that was valuable in my life? And then after several weeks, after several months, there began to breathe the word to us, I think there is gonna be a vaccine. And that word that we rarely cared about all of a sudden gave us hope in the midst of dread and despair and difficulty. And what Jesus does for us is colossally bigger than that. It takes the reality of our lives that are stuck in sin, that we, as we look and say, is there any future? Is there any life beyond life? And the birth of Jesus points us ultimately to the empty tomb of the same Jesus. And that gives us, right now at Christmas and forever, hope that this is not all there is. So we rest in that very hope. Now, what would it look like? What might it look like if we were to give it away? Is it possible? Well, it is. First of all, you need to be able to, and I like to remind you regularly of this, you need to be able to see people with the same kind of eyes that God sees you and me. You need to see past the veneer of the jokes or the sarcasm or the cynicism. And you need to look and realize where people are truly wrestling with loneliness or depression or despair. And then we begin to build bridges to earn the right and the privilege to share the good news that is way beyond the birth of just a baby. We've tried to make it really easy or easier for you this Advent season. My staff worked hard. In fact, a number of people from the church, what they've done is they have written devotionals, and it's really fun. Every 7 a.m. Between now and Christmas, it's going to hit your email box. We have a devotional, and each week we're going to focus on the particular facet of the gift of God. So this week, you're going to be receiving devotionals that remind you to hold out and give gratitude and examine the beauty of the hope we have in Christ. And a simple way you can give that gift away is even sharing it forwarding it, talking about it, send it to people on social media. Say, hey, you're welcome to join us. We would love to have you. This is a gift from our congregation to you to help you get through not only the tough time right now of life, but the difficulty we have in being separated from God. And then the other simple thing that I love, gosh, we've been doing this for so long. I love this part of our church. We have a gift for you card. They are simply our way. What I'd like to do, we have nearly 500 people, over 500, that call Aurora Campus home. What we want to do is we want to blanket the area with over 2,000 gifts that will help bless and communicate the name of Jesus. So hopefully each week you'll take and say, hey, how could I give a gift to someone who needs hope? And next week when we look at peace, you'll look and say, what could I do? Is it write a letter and restore peace in a relationship that's broken? Could I take somebody that I know is in despair or struggling, and could this week, could I write them a card, or could I send them a meal, and could I include that little card in it to say, this is to remind you, there is hope. This is always about us being the body of Christ, celebrating the advent of Jesus by gratitude for what God has done for us and generosity in helping send that out to the rest of the world. I can't wait to see what God does as we marvel in the gift, as we truly behold the gift of God. Pray with me, would you? Father God, we want to do exactly that. We want to know and recognize that you are the giver of every good and perfect gift. We want to live our lives so that it reflects the gratitude that we feel. We want our heart's condition to be exactly right in recognizing your magnificent love for us. So we thank you because of Christ and in his name. Amen.
Mary, did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you deliver will soon deliver. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to the blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm? Your baby
baby boy is Lord of all creation. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nations? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect lamb and the sleeping child you're holding? Is the great I am.
It's time for me to send you out and to remind you to be the church, to take the power of hope that is the gift of God and look for ways that God will allow you to share that gift. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus, the love of God the Father, the constant fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide upon each one of you until we shall meet again or until our Savior comes, and then forever. Amen. Go and have a great week in Christ.